Hello class 8 students, hope you all are well. Today we will going to discuss about the chapter 10, Deep Water Horizon Oil Spill. In the previous class, we have covered some of the disasters like the flood in Assam and the earthquake that was occurred in Nepal. And in this chapter, we will also discuss about the disaster like the oil spill and that was occurred in 2010 April. In the Mexico, in the Gulf of Mexico. Okay, at first we will study where it was occurred. Even with that, what are the different causes of that oil spill? Okay students, let's start this chapter. Deep Water Horizon Oil Spill. So what is the oil spill? At first we have to know what is it. An oil spill is the release of liquid petroleum into the environment, especially in marine areas. Marine areas like the seas, gulf, coast, any kind of marine areas. If there is some accidental release, not only release, it can be said as the accidental release of the liquid petroleum into the environment. It is a man-made disaster. In the previous two, one was earthquake and another one was the flood, and those of two was more or less physical or the natural, and some kinds of human activities also was responsible, but this is totally man-made, or you can say an anthropological disaster. Human being is the sole cause of that. There is so many causes and that are mainly accidentally occurred. We will discuss what are the different causes. An oil spill involves the accidental release of oil into a water body. The source of the oil can be a tanker, an offshore drilling rig, or an underwater pipeline. It is hazardous to the marine life and environment. So, oil rig, it is a new term. What is a oil rig? You can say it is a just structure with various equipments, various machines, and what does it work? It just drill the oil wells, okay, and it is called as the oil rig. Now the source of the oil can be a tanker. From where the oil will be released or oil spill, we are just discussing about the spill, means the accidental release. From where it will be released, it can be a tanker, from that the oil will be released, or any kind of offshore drilling tank, or you can say the drilling rig, okay, or an underwater pipeline can be there. So the you can say the floating platform from where the petroleum are mainly extracted, there is the chances of the oil spill, and it is very much hazardous to the marine life and the environment. So many marine lives like the marine plants, marine animals, sea animals that lives in the marine, and it will be very much hazardous and harmful for them. The Deepwater Horizon oil spill was one of the worst oil spills in the history of the world. It is also known as the Gulf of Mexico oil spill. Why it is known as the Gulf of Mexico oil spill? Because it was mainly occurred in the Gulf of Mexico. Okay, we will discuss. At first the location. If you want to know about the Gulf of Mexico oil spill, then at first you should have to know where Mexico is located, right? So have some look, student. In the junction of the North America and South America, this is it. Okay, I'm just increasing the size. Like this is the North America, okay, this much part, and this is the South America. So in this junction, here lies the Gulf of Mexico. Now this portion is the North America and here lies the South America. So this is the Gulf of Mexico. Now where the oil rig or the deep water horizon oil rig is located? It is located in this much area. Like here it is the Alabama, it is the Florida, and in this much area the deep water horizon oil rig is located. At first you should have to know where it is located. So have some look. The oil found on the coast is this area. Here the oil are found in the coast region, coastal areas. Okay. And here is the deep water horizon oil rig, where the accidental release of the oil, or you can say the worst ever oil spill in the world history, was mainly occurred. We will discuss the various reasons of that. So we have already discussed where Mexico is located and where was the deep water horizon oil spill. Now another thing we would see is the what is the oil rig. I have already said that it is a structure with the various equipments, various machines, and that mainly what it does, it just drills the oil well. So have some look, students. This is the picture of the oil rig. Mexico oil rig is there, or you can say the deep water horizon oil rig is there. And here the accidental release of the oil or the oil spill was mainly occurred. Now we will going to discuss what was the different causes of that oil spill. The deep water horizon oil rig was located in the Gulf of Mexico near the Mississippi River Delta in the United States. So from the map you have already seen the location where the Mississippi Delta is there, like I am showing. So here have some look, student, where the Mississippi Delta, like the Mississippi River is there, and this is the Mississippi Delta where it was mainly occurred. Okay. So Mississippi River Delta in the United States. The rig was installed at the Macondo Prospect, an oil producing region in the Gulf of Mexico. It was owned by an offshore oil drilling company called the British oil drilling company called the Transocean. So you have to remember what was the company, was the Transocean. The rig was leased to the company by the British Petroleum, or you can say the BP. So the company was owned by the Transocean company, and then that was leased to the company like the BP or the British Petroleum. That is why this disaster is also called as the BP oil spill. Why BP oil spill? Because the British Petroleum oil spill, it is also called as in this name. The rig was built in South Korea by the Hyundai Heavy Industries. Okay, students. Now, the disaster. On April 20, 2010, an explosion on the deepwater horizon Macondo oil well drilling platform killed 11 workers and started the largest marine oil spill in world history, releasing millions of barrels of oil into the Gulf of Mexico. So where the rig was located, I have already shown you, student. So you have some idea, like if there is some millions of barrels of oil are just released accidentally, then they will add into the water, and that will be a hazardous effect that will affected the whole marine life also. Even with that, 11 workers that they worked in that spill, they were also killed in this hazardous disaster. And when it was occurred? It was occurred in 2010 on April 20. Now the causes. According to the experts, 8 disastrous failures led to the explosion that destroys the oil rig. So not only one disastrous failures, but also 8. So many causes are there. This incident happened due to a series of technological failures rather than a single one. That means not only one reason was there, there are so many reasons. That is why this spill was mainly occurred. Like first one is the construction material. So in all cases there was some failure, there was some mistake. That is why these disastrous, you can say disastrous oil spill was mainly occurred. At first we have the construction material. The borehole at the bottom of the rig that had been capped with cement to prevent any leakage. The gas and oil began to leak through it into the pipe, flowing to the surface. So at the bottom of the rig, that is capped with the bore hole. So this is a term you have to remember, some technical term, like the bore hole is that. What does it do? It will just cap the bottom of the rig, and also with cement. It is capped with cement. That is why it just prevents any kinds of leakages there. But it was failed to prevent the leakage. That is why the gas and oil began to leak through it, and they will add into the water, into the pipe flowing to the surface. So first one was the construction material. That was also a great failure. Number two is the valve. What is a valve? A valve is a device attached to the pipe or tube that controls the flow of air or a liquid. This device stops, starts, or controls the flow of the fluid. The pipe that is used to extract the oil contains two such mechanical valves. A fault in the valve led to the leakage of methane gas to the surface of the oil rig. So the valve that is attached to the device or to the pipe that also controls the flow of air or a liquid, any kind of air, liquid, so it will control. But there is some fault was also there, that is why leakage of very harmful methane gas to the surface of the oil rig. Next is the misinterpretation of the pressure data. In all cases there was some faults, that is why it was caused with the so many causes. 8 disastrous failures led to the explosion. Next is the misinterpretation of the pressure data. The staff on duty on the oil rig had carried out various pressure tests to find out whether the valve was operating properly or not. However, they failed to detect the fault in the valve. They had incorrectly analyzed that the oil was properly sealed. So they thought the oil was properly sealed, but in actual case it was not like that. That is why the valve was failure and the oil was leaked. Next is the delayed response. It is the one of the most important point is the delayed response. What does it mean? The crew at the surface failed to notice the flow of oil and gas towards the surface. The oil leak was discovered only 2 days after it actually started. So disastrous. What a disastrous kind of failure it was. I think delayed response, like if there is some leakage, if there is some fault was there, then they should be highly monitored, and some alarm will also be there to monitor them if there is some leakage. And then and there, if it was just checked then and there and monitored, then it would have been managed properly. But the leak was discovered only 2 days after the actually it was started. So you can say the response was also delayed. That is why a very disastrous form was mainly happened. If it was checked properly, it was monitored properly, then it would not have been like that. Next is the gas alarm. The onboard gas detection system that was supposed to trigger warning failed to work. So in these kinds of you can say platforms, some gas alarm or the onboard, that means the if there is some, you can say the floated platform or the floating platform, onboard gas detection system is also there. And that was mainly what does they do? If there is some leakage, then the alarm will be just ring. That is why all the members, all the workers will be get the notification. The onboard gas detection system that was supposed to trigger warning failed to work. So after the gas spill is there, that will trigger to warning, but the warning system or you can say the gas alarm, that was also have a great failure. So in all cases some technological faults was there, and the human negligibility or you can say the negligence is also there. All these leads to the deep water horizon oil spill to make it a disastrous failure. Last is the battery failure of the blowout preventer. So the blowout preventer is a machine that is also in the floating platform, or you can say the onboard platform, is the blowout preventer. The battery also of that blowout preventer was also failure. What is a blowout preventer? At first we should have to know. Here it is given. Blowout preventers are a large specialized valves or the similar mechanical devices that is mainly used to seal, control or to monitor the oil and gas wells to prevent the blowout. So blowout preventer is there. And what does it do? It is also a valve or similar valve kind of mechanical devices, and that is mainly used to seal, control, monitor all kinds of gas, oil leaks is there. So it will seal, it will control, even with that monitor properly. But the battery of that system or that devices blowout preventer was also failed in this case. The explosion destroyed the control lines which the crew was using in an attempt to close the safety valves. Okay, that is why the blowout preventer also did not work properly. So this is the reasons of the deep water horizon oil spills in Mexico that was occurred. Okay students, we have completed the various reasons of the deep water horizon oil spills. We will end this class here, and in the next class we will discuss various effects and what is the different mitigation strategies that was mainly done in the to make it properly managed in the deep water horizon oil spill. Okay students, thank you.